Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to JavaScript interview questions, 10 minutes. So we are actually trying to cover most of the questions which you can face in JavaScript interviews. So let's talk one by one. So you may face a question, what are the different ways in which you can create an object? So there are different ways. You can use a new object constructor, or you can use object.create. You can just pass the existing object or pass the null. Or the basic simple way of creating object is using object literal, or you can create a function like using constructor. This is the functions, and you can use a new keyword onto that function name. By calling that constructor, you can create an object. So there are different ways: object literal, object.create, new object, or you can extend an existing object using prototype inheritance and all. Okay, what is a prototype chain? This questions justifies in two different ways. There are different functions we are writing, and then you are actually inheriting the properties of one function into another functions, and then like function A, a function B is inheriting the properties of function A, and function C is inheriting the properties of function B, right? So this is kind of a prototype chain we are creating. So function C is extending the prototype or inheriting the prototype of function B. Function B is inheriting the prototype of function A. So this is a kind of chain. So whenever we try to access some property in function C, it will try to check in its local properties. If it is not found, then it will check in the prototypes. Same thing happens with objects, like how we extend the properties of one object into another. Prototype chaining is used to build a new type of object based on the existing ones. That is correct. So what we are doing, we are creating the new object from the existing object. Okay, when we try to access some local property in that object, if that not found, then it try to check that property in the proto or prototype of the parent property, because there is a prototype chain or proto chain exist. Proto chain exists in the object, prototype chain exists in the functions. Okay, so whenever we try to get the property, it will check first. If it is not found, then it will check that in the prototype properties. What is the purpose of array slice method? So there are different ways in the array prototypes, slice, push, pop, map, for each, filter, sum, every, all these methods are there, right? So what all these methods are doing, just playing around with the object. Sum returns the new array, sum do the changes in the existing array. That is the basic difference. So slice method returns the selected elements in an array as a new array object. So what slice is doing, it's not changing the existing array, it is just extracting out the elements from the array and it is giving it to you. Okay, when you do the slice 0 or slice minus 1, when you do the slice minus 1, it actually gives the elements from the right side. When you do the slice 0, it gives you the complete array itself. You can use to create a copy of an array using slice 0. What is the purpose of array splice method? Okay, we talking about slice and splice, so you should be clear about what these two methods are. So what is slice method? Slice method returns the selected element in an array as a new array object. Clear? It selects the element starting at a given start argument and adds at the given optional argument. So the end argument is optional. So it selects the element from the starting, given a start argument and end argument. So there are two arguments it is taking, start index and end index. Now let's talk about splice. Splice method is used either to add and remove the item to or from an array, and then returns the removed items. The first argument specifies the array position for insertion or deletion, whereas this optional second argument indicates the number of elements to be deleted. Okay, so it's also doing a splice method is just like adding and removing from an array. This is what splice is doing. Now here you can understand the basic difference, because this is people gets confused what is slice and splice. Slice doesn't modify the original array. Okay, so slice is immutable, like map and filter. It's not changing the existing array. Splice modifies the original array. It means it is mutable. So whenever you do splice, okay, it will change the existing original array. Splice returns the deleted elements as an array. I mean, it is changing the existing one and it is just returning the deleted element as an array. Returns the subset of original array. okay, because you are doing the slicing. So you are providing the start and end index, so you will get the final output from there. Okay, used to pick the elements from the array, and splice used to insert or delete the element from or to array. Okay, clear now? Now, what are the first class functions? What are the different ways of writing of functions and all? So in JavaScript, functions are first class objects. First class functions means when function in that language are treated like any other variables, because you can create anonymous functions, you can assign the functions to some variables, you can pass functions into another functions, you can return a function from another functions, right? So why the functions are first class citizens, or whatever you can call it, because functions can be returned by another functions or can be assigned to a value or variable, right? Because this handler, here we retort the arrow function, so handler is a variable where the function is assigned, anonymous function. Now higher order functions, it's kind of same related to the first class citizen, which is function. Is higher order functions are those functions which are accepting the function as an argument and returning function as a return value. I mean, you talk about the callback functions because they are accepting function as an argument and returning function as a callback. So this is increment, right? Higher order increment. So higher order is taking a callback as a function, callback as a function, it is returning another function. Any basic callback example is an example of higher order function. You talk about array dot prototype dot for each map filter, all these are kind of higher order functions because they are accepting a function as an argument. Curry function. Currying is the process of taking the function with multiple arguments and turning it into a sequence of functions where one function is returning another function is returning another function. Okay, this is not that surprising. It's just like a nested functions. Outer function is returning inner function is returning another inner function which is defined inside it. So when you call the outer function, that is actually you are doing a partial invocation of function. Okay, consider it like this: curry function one. Here you are doing the partial invocation of this function. You are just passing a as an argument, right? Then again you will assign this to some other variable and you will call it again. So instead of, you are doing that like this. So here this function is being called three times: 1, 2, 3. One is returning another function. This is returning another function. Then we are passing another argument 2. Then we are passing another argument 3 in this. Okay, this is called currying, or currying is named after mathematical Haskell curry, and by applying currying, an array turns into the unary function. So what is just a simple, if we talk it in the simple terms, it's just a function which keeps returning another functions, and you can write it either with the help of partial invocations, and you can call that function with all these arguments one by one, 1, 2, 3. Okay, finally it will return this number. And it uses the closer extensively, because when you call this function with the one argument, it actually, this one is being stored inside the inner function's closure. Difference between war and let, I hope everybody should be aware of this. This is the ESX feature. We are now writing the variables with the help of const and let. So war is has a functional scope. War keyword allows you to do the hoisting inside a function. War keyword, war variable is having the function level scope. It has a but let has a block level scope. It doesn't get hoisted, introduced in ES6, and this is the core feature of ES5. Okay, let's see more videos in coming sessions.